Hey everyone, so today we're going to go ahead and learn how to clean a Super Nintendo controller. So first, the items you're going to need: rubbing alcohol, a flat head screwdriver to open it up, some cotton swabs, and just to clean up the mess at the end, some Lysol wipes because of all the grime that will fall out of your controller. So this is a used controller I actually just picked up today. Doesn't act as nice. In fact, even the rubber right here is almost ripped off. But I noticed that the start and select buttons are not as sensitive as they should be, as well as actually on the other controller that it came with, the start button didn't work at all. And I was able to clean it, and the start button now works like brand new. So let's go ahead and dive into it and begin the process of cleaning the controller. So what you're first going to do is go ahead and unscrew these 5 screws with your flathead. Okay, so now that we have them all screwed off, go ahead and place them to the side where they're safe, because we'll have to reinsert them back later. Now, what you want to do is carefully remove off the top, like so, okay? Nothing is attached here. Now, what you can do here is actually, can't see too well, or maybe you can, but there is a lot, there is a handful of dust and just crud and dirt all around the edges. So what I first want to do is go ahead and get some of my rubbing alcohol here. I use the cap to dip it in. Go ahead and dip cotton swab in there. And what you'll do is just go ahead and soak in the edges like so. And you'll see there's just a lot of dirt that's coming off. You can see the cotton swab is completely brown. And you'll just want to continue this process for a while. All right, now we have the back cover completely cleaned. No more crud. So we'll go ahead and put that off to the side for now. Now we're going to go ahead and move on to the control board. So what we'll go ahead and do is first unwind that. It'll be pretty easy to remember how to put it back in place. What you want to do next is pretty simple. First, go ahead and remove the triggers, which will be also attached to a pin, like so. You can go ahead and put the pins to the side, as you will not need them until you put them back in. Now what you can do is go ahead and clean the triggers. So we grab more alcohol. And this is all the grime that accumulates after years and years and years and years and years of playing. Lots of dirt and grease, food, Doritos, whatever. So those are both clean now. All right. I'm going to go ahead and put some more alcohol in the cap. Now, moving on, I'll go ahead and remove the rubber pieces here. Like so. Okay. As you can see, these actually look pretty good, but just in case, we're going to give them a tiny little bit of clean. Like I said, I am OCD a little bit here, so just be very gentle because you don't want to accidentally rip this part off, okay? So this part's actually what makes contact. There we go, all right. Very good, very good. As you can see, the cotton swab is not very dirty because this part did not get very dirty to begin with, so I am not too worried about that, but we still wanted to get a good clean. All right. Very nice. Okay, so those are now done. Keep those with the triggers. Next, what you want to do is go ahead and pull this out nicely, like so. Ta-da! As you can see, these buttons have just crud all around the rubber. Same here, very dusty. So what we'll go ahead and do is put this to the side for now. I'll go ahead and remove this bit here. Again, just more rubber, but handy to clean. So we'll go ahead and clean that. See, that's got some kind of dead skin or something on it. Not something I want in my controller. Just knowing it's there irks me. Okay, didn't need to clean that too much, like crazy, honestly. Go ahead and just rub these bits a little bit. I'm sure we're gonna get plenty of dust. Let's check it out. Yep, pretty dark. Okay, pretty confident about this piece, so I'm gonna go ahead and put that to the side. Now the actual buttons clearly show lots of dirt on them. So we'll go ahead and get a new cotton swab for this part. Go ahead and just pull them out individually, okay? Like so. Gonna go ahead and just go around like so, okay? This one's pretty good. Now what I'm gonna do is actually go in the controller and get some of that grime off. Came through the fingers. Okay. It's not bad. Not bad, okay. I'll go ahead and move on. I'm gonna go ahead and put this back in. There it is, okay. So, we're gonna go ahead and get the next one. I guess I could just go from this direction. Same thing.
Looks pretty dirty.
Now I would say this is much cleaner than before. Okay, so we'll go ahead and put the buttons back in. So now that part's done. Next, got the control pad here. Up, down, and all that. Go ahead and put some more alcohol. As you can see, this is really grimy. So you're really gonna make sure that Q-tip is soaked, because you are really gonna have to get into those corners. Get every bit out. All right. You can see, very gross. And the cotton swabs do not end. I just keep going. I always like to use a dry one afterwards. Just helps get a lot of the extra stuff off. As you can see, I accumulated again another dark cotton swab. I'd say this is pretty clean at this point. It's a pretty big visual difference. I'll go ahead and clean this inner part here because it is a little dirty. Okay. We are in business. I'll go ahead and put this back in, and we're set. Next, before we move on to the actual electric board, I'll clean some of the plastic on the inside. And then, like we did the previous one, I will focus on the outside, which is extremely dirty. So I'm just about running out of alcohol again. Should have just filled it to the top. Okay. Go ahead and grab that. And we move on. Okay. Clean as a whistle. All right. Now we move on. This whole section is complete. I go ahead and put that to the side. Next, we'll do the board. So the main issue typically when it comes to these Super Nintendo controllers is that the start and select button sometimes just don't work. Most of the time it's just the start button. What I like to do is clean the sensors here, or these aren't sensors obviously, but they touch the sensors on the board. So I'll go ahead and just clean these just a tad bit. Look at that. Nasty. And then what I do is go ahead and wipe each individual contact. And if you can see closely, they don't look as clean as they should be. So what you gotta do is rub it until no more black comes off. Be gentle with it. You don't want to go too hard. That one's good. See, that one had some issues. That one needed some cleaning. Go ahead and move on to the next. Yep. All right. Very good. So now the sensitivity should be much better on those buttons. Next, we'll move on to the rest of the buttons here. Go ahead and just clean that up nicely. Shouldn't be too much coming off on these. They tend to be fairly clean for the most part, as I've noticed. Okay, next you want to go ahead and remove this. This is typically the most nasty part of the whole thing because so much dirt enters through the crack. You want to clean out the rubber like so. And this is probably where you're going to get the most dirt when it comes to any of the rubber pieces. And as you can see, it's quite dirty. All right. So now that we got that clean, go ahead and go to the underside. Again, you want to be gentle. You don't want to accidentally rip those little black pieces off. As you can see, a little bit of black's coming off, and that's just because of the contact it has with the board. All right, so now that we've got that clean, I'm going to go ahead and this is probably going to be my last Q-tip I'm going to need, which just happens to be the last bit of alcohol I'll need. Okay. As you can see, there's the select and start button. Now these need cleaning. As you can see, you can barely even see the white line. And that's a good indicator it needs cleaning. Now you can completely see it. I'll get a closer view for you guys so you guys can see what I'm talking about. All right, continuing on. Let's see, is this the clean part? Yes, it is. All right. Gonna go ahead and clean this one. And as you can see, they are both now completely cleaned up. Now I'll take the dry end and just get the rest off. Make sure there's no more black coming off. If there's black coming off, that means there's still more to clean. Yep, see, that one still has some trouble, so I'm just going to go ahead and get another rub. And hopefully this will do it. All right, I would say that is pretty clean. So now there is the assembly. Okay, so you got your top part like this, right? Okay. So what you're gonna do is take this part, go ahead and make sure these holes line up with the small inserts here. Fairly easy to get in. As long as they're lining up, the controller will do the rest. All right, next you've got this part here. Oh, and I actually forgot to clean it. Go ahead and get that. Now that was a lot of dirt. Oof, my gosh. I only did the underside. Totally forgot about the other side. All right. So, nice and clean. All right. That was a lot of dirt. Okay. Gonna go ahead and line it up like so. As you can see, there's the small hole right here. You just put it right there in your gold. All right, next, you have the start and select button. Okay. So, I have it right. I'm gonna look quickly. Okay, that's what I thought. I want the start button to have the good rubber, so I'm gonna give it this one. All right, so that's good. Now go ahead and put the electronic board in, nice and easy, like so. It'll just nicely rest in there. Make sure these two shoulder pieces fit in. Go ahead and insert those back in there. All right. Next, you have these pins. Go ahead and insert them into the holes right there that line up with the trigger. So as you can see, this is the right trigger. So if you're holding it, this side's going to be the right side. You're going to go ahead and put it in like that. Now we're good on that. We got the left side. And we are almost done. Okay. Now, what am I missing? Oh, of course. This is what I'm missing. Do this. There we go. Now we're all set for the rest. Go ahead and insert the back down in there firmly until you can see that it's sealed on all the edges. Go ahead and grab your flathead and all right, now we have a perfectly fine Super Nintendo controller. So now what I like to do in the end is grab a Lysol wipe, get any excess dirt that may have fallen out onto the outside. So make sure it's nice and clean, disinfected, because you don't know what house it comes from. Go ahead and do the cord. Do the end, like so. Wait for it to dry a little bit and clean up your station. So next I'll show you guys the controller working in action. As you can see, I can show you guys the start button. That's how easily it will. I don't got pressed too hard. Very softly, just perfect connection. I'm not mashing to get it to pause. And that's the exact same perfect sensitivity you'll have for all of the other buttons. There you go.